Hey there, fools. Big T here, and bear with me. I'm still recovering from a summer cold, and we all know how amazing those are. I've been kind of holding my channel hostage with video uploads because I've been trying to finish my Versus video, Wii Versus GameCube video. It is stellar, by the way. It's ballooned way out of control, though. It's like 22 minutes long, but it's hopefully going to be worth it. But I've been not uploading stuff because I've been trying to get that out. I have like 10 or 11 really good videos ready to go. And so I want to kind of, you know, that video is going to take another couple days at least. It's already, you know, voice edited. It just needs to be, you know, the images and stuff need to be put in. So, like I said, I have like 10 or 11 videos that are ready to go. And I figured, let me just at least put out one of those while you guys are still waiting for the Wii versus GameCube video. So this is one of them. As the title says, this device could have saved Wii U. And, you know, that's being a little bit facetious. There was probably nothing that could do that with the Wii U the way it was. You know, and I mean saved by commercially. Obviously, I love the Wii U. The games are great. But I think there weren't enough games, and this could have added value to it. As you can see here, this is the GameCube, and like I said, I've been working on this Wii versus GameCube video, so it has me thinking a lot about the GameCube lately. That's kind of what sparked this video, and obviously this is the GameCube. As you can see, in the video that I'm doing, I'm going to be discussing faults and good things about the GameCube. And as you said, the little handle there on the back, weird situation there. Just giving you a good look at the GameCube. I'm sure you've all seen one if you're a Nintendo fan. So anyway, here's the GameCube player, or not the GameCube player, the Game Boy player. That's the disc that's required for the Game Boy player to work, and that's kind of what this video is about. The Game Boy player is kind of an oddity because I'm not sure at that time that people were looking for a device to play their Game Boy Advance games. It also plays regular Game Boy games too. As you can see, this is let's get a better shot of this here. Dynasty Warriors Advance for the Game Boy Advance. Like I said, I don't think the Game Boy or the people were really looking for a Game Boy player, even in the way they were looking for one on the Super Nintendo. The Super Game Boy played Game Boy games on your TV through your Super Nintendo as well. So let's take this bad boy off. This is the hardware itself for the Game Boy player. It's a little dusty because I don't really move this much, as you can see. And you're probably wondering, what the heck am I talking about here? Well, this device here, obviously, like I said, plays Game Boy Advance games through your GameCube onto your TV. It's a pretty clever little device. But again, like I said, I don't think people were really looking for this at the time. But as we all know, there was a huge kind of battle, if you will, during the Wii U 3DS era. And one of the big things was that people were really, really envious of the 3DS and how much attention it was getting over the Wii U. And so you'd have all these directs about, you know, with Wii U and 3DS games, and the 3DS games would always overshadow or outshine the Wii U games. And here's my gamepad, which is dusty as hell because I haven't played Wii U much lately. But this is right here. This gamepad is basically your bottom screen for the DS or 3DS. You know, it's a touch screen, it has the same exact capacitance touchscreen as the 3DS and DS, and it makes it would have made perfect sense for Nintendo to have a 3DS player for the Wii U. And a lot of that envious stuff that people had with the Wii U and the 3DS, like I said, at the time, people really wanted those games, you know, wanted Wii U to have more focus. There wouldn't have been that envy had the Wii U had a 3DS player, and you could play your 3DS games and your DS games on your Wii U on your TV. And this would have added a lot of value at the time, especially for the Wii U. You know, it would have had to be something that came out a little bit later in Wii U's life, like maybe 2.5 years, like maybe the summer of 2015 or something. This could have got announced at E3 to come out shortly after or right there. But this would have been a great thing, you know, that you could play your... It just makes too much sense, you know, because even if you like emulate, you play the Wii U has has DS games that you can download on the virtual console to play on your Wii U. But it does this weird kind of, you got to hold it sideways kind of situation. I'm just gonna tighten up my Game Boy player before I forget. Put it back here. It kind of, you know, you had it kind of just, you know, would put the game sideways. It would be or the, you know, long way on the TV, and both screens would be on that, you know, would be on the TV. And it's just like, why this is weird. You have a touch screen here with the gamepad. Why wouldn't you make the gamepad the touch screen and then your TV obviously the top screen of the 3DS, so you could separate the two? I'm guessing that would have took more software. It would have took more engineering or whatever as far as the software for the emulation goes. But so what? Like, there's some great 3DS games. Look at this library of mine here. This is not all of them, but here's one of my cases for my 3DS games. And there's some DS too, two Zelda games. Like, this would have been a no-brainer to take this Pokemon here. And I'm being a little jokey here. I'm going to pull out the Game Boy game and just slide it in there. But, you know, you could have did that instead. You know, it'd be perfect, you know. And you could just, you know, put it in there. Obviously, it'd be different on the Wii U. Let me adjust my camera so we can see what, you know, where it would obviously go. We have the, the GameCube. The GameCube controller adapter, so you can just put it right here into the front. Could have had some kind of dongle. I obviously saw the mock-up basically in my thumbnail. Maybe I'll put it on screen again. You can just plug it in here into one of the USBs, or maybe it would take two USBs for the power consumption. And you just take your, you know, 3DS game or DS game and slide it right in the front of that. And you know, it wouldn't be the most intuitive looking thing, but it would still work, obviously. And boom, there you go. I mean, it would have been great. Your TV could have been your top screen, like I said, and the gamepad would have been the touch screen bottom screen. And it just makes, again, so much sense, especially for a gamepad that was, you know, as far as games go, it wasn't as utilized as much. And it would have been a great selling point, I think, for the gamepad, especially even more of a selling point. It would have added more value to the gamepad and to the Wii U overall, like being able to play Luigi's Mansion Dark Moon on my TV using the Wii U's gamepad. And, you know, that would have been great. You know, that's the kind of thing that, you know, once the Wii U stopped selling or started to show that it wasn't going to be a big seller, that's the kind of thing that Nintendo, old Nintendo, would have brought out and said, all right, we're going to bring this out and add a little value. We're going to sell this little piece of hardware, the 3DS player, add some value to everybody's Wii U. And that would have been like a great thing. And I don't know why they didn't do it. But anyway, that's it for this video. What do you guys think? Do you think the the 3DS player for the Wii U would have been a great idea. I said saved, but I don't think it would have saved it, but it definitely would have added a lot more value to it, and it would have pushed some sales, I think, because 3DS is obviously a popular device, and it was peaking basically at that time, and for them to announce a 3DS player for the Wii U then would have been great. So I think it would have definitely helped the sales, maybe, you know, pushed it over 15 million, maybe going towards, you know, GameCube numbers. Adding value to the, you know, Wii U would have, you know, with that would have been great. You'd have that whole library open up to the Wii U. So yeah, let me know what you guys think in the comments below. As always, thank you for watching and listening, and now see you fools next time. Peace out.
Oh yeah, one more thing. Play Nintendo, fools.